everybody, welcome to a new video. Today we are going to show you how to fix the error of that it says hard drive not found, you know, all those things. So the system goes there, and what it does, it goes and skips the hard drive, diagnosing your PC. That's what it's saying. But now it shows the system error, the error which says hard drive not installed. So let's see. I tried to go to diagnostics, and I did diagnose the entire system. Then I saw what was the problem. So now I'm just showing you what error we see. It could be the same error you have, but then let's see what we're gonna do. Coming on, let's give it some time. Nothing much happened, guys. It just took me here. If hardware problems, so it's gonna fix that. It's gonna go and pass through that. If it passes the test, if everything's not going well, then we're gonna try to see how to fix this. Sometimes it takes time. Let's see. We're gonna all try all options to see if we can win on this, and we see if we can fix our computer right. So don't worry, you're gonna see the solution. Let it do what it has to do. It said 47 seconds, but it passed that long ago. But let's see. It tells us this is the problem. Dell support has detected a failure component on your system that requires immediate attention. Go to this and this and this. You can see that's the problem we have. Now that error code is 0. You can see the error code. That error code, the error code is 2000-0151. That error code, if you go to the internet, it shows that your hard drive, it's not working properly. So I have to change my hard drive now. I'm gonna show you. I switched off the machine and then I switch it on. Then I have to press F2. When you press F2, it's gonna take you to BIOS. F2. I think I was late. Let me switch it off. I'm gonna switch it off, then I switch on back. Then before it displays anything, you have to press F2. Then you can see now I'm not late. It shows me that. So it puts me here. So what I have to do, look at this. Look at these settings. We have to click on boot sequence. Boot sequence, it's in legacy, it's in UIF. It simply means this is not working for it. So what you got to do is to do what? To change to this. So you can see it's difficult to do that because it's disabled. So what you do, you go to your security and you say boot, secure boot. Up on secure boot, you have to click on enter secure boot enabled. So since it's enabled, I'm gonna disable that. Then I say okay, I apply, and just save it. After saving that, I can go back to advanced boot. Let me see, try to select this and apply. It doesn't give me that. Okay, since it doesn't give me that, What can I do? Let me see. Okay, if I got secure boot, yes, now it's enabled. You can see after doing that, it enabled me to do that. It allowed me to do that. So I'm gonna make it go to legacy boot. So if I put it to legacy boot, then I'm gonna say apply. After applying, then I'm gonna save it. After saving that, I'm gonna exit. Then I say, because I think legacy was not working for me. UEFI was not working for me, let's try legacy. So after that, applying everything, we saved, then we exit and restart our computer. We'll see if it's gonna work. See if it's gonna work. If it works, then we're gonna be fine. If it doesn't, that simply means we're gonna change our hard drive. You can see no device found, press any key to reboot the machine. You can see that there's no device found, so press any key to reboot the machine. Okay, so you can see when I put it on legacy boot, nothing comes. It simply means the hard drive is having some issues. So what are we gonna do, guys, to tell you that the hard drive has an issue and you're gonna believe me? You can see it doesn't detect any hard drive. So it simply means maybe this machine was thrown down or something happened, then it shook the hard drive inside, then the hard drive got detached somehow, or it got corrupted somehow. So now this is what's gonna happen. You're gonna do what? I'm gonna switch off the computer and I show you what I'm trying to say to mean. What I'm trying to mean here, I'm gonna go to F12, switch off the computer, switch it on, go to F12, press F12, then you go here. I want to make sure to tell you that the hard drive is the problem we have. So then you select diagnostics. After that diagnostics, then you say enter. When you say enter, it's gonna start now what? Diagnose your machine and test each and every component on the system. So let's see what it's gonna tell us. It might take longer than what expected, but we wanna make sure before we open the computer and replace the hard drive that is it the one, because we've tested three things, we've seen that the hard drive has a problem, you understand? So this is the last thing. We're using the Dell installed software which checks all the components of the machine. So you're gonna see what's gonna happen. So you can wait, or you can click here. They're gonna show you, can see this arrow, the arrow here. You can click this arrow, touch the arrow. If it does not, you can say mouse is not right, escape to stop testing. We don't want to stop testing. Okay, see the arrow took us there. You can see that LCD tick, OS boot path tick, hard drive is not ticked. You can see hard drive not ticked. USB is ticked, USB webcam is ticked. You can see everything here is ticked. Processor is okay, but now you can see that our hard drive is not yet ticked. So simply means now this is the third thing which is giving you the hard drive problem. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna wait. We're gonna wait and see what's gonna be the results we're gonna get from the hard drive. So the computer is gonna finish. It's not yet done. You see it shows like 1 minute 24 seconds. That simply means we should give it time to show us, but those are false numbers. It might take a bit longer. So if I pass that, it simply means I'm gonna open the machine, then I replace the hard drive, or I take it out, I take it back, so that I put it out and put it in back to see everything if it goes well. If it doesn't go well, simply means I have to try to change the hard drive again. You understand? I have to put a new hard drive for that. It's gonna show us what's going on. still counting, you can see it's counting. Sometimes it takes a little while to bring you the results, but the results gonna come. It's gonna pop up and show you what is not right with the machine. So whatever is not right is what you're gonna fix. So, but now we've seen all our test points on our hard drive. See? Give it time. It's gonna work, guys. Now you can see the beep. You can see the beep. Since you've seen the beep, macro, we're showing our true you can see that. I'm sorry about the noise which came out, but now this is the beep on the thing on the machine, and the machine shows that we have this error. This error code, when we type it into the internet, we get that error code points to the hard drive. So you have to change your hard drive, otherwise your laptop is not going to work. So that's the thing we've tried to show you that what could be possibly wrong with that. So we use the software, and this is making a lot of noise here. Guys, this is unbelievable. The laptop is back on its best Windows screen. You know what happened? Okay, this is something I didn't show you. Whatever I did, you have to do it. But I didn't even open the laptop. I didn't touch anything after what you've seen. What I did, I went to settings again, and I managed to do what? To reverse. Remember we put in UIF, then we took it to, it was from legacy, then we put it to UIF, after UIF, then put it in UIF, after, then put it back in legacy boot, then it's gonna work for you. That's what I did, guys. I went to F12, I switched off the machine. Like, let me switch off the machine now. I'm gonna say switch off the machine. Say shut down. I'm gonna shut it down. Don't touch the hard drive. It fixed itself. I thought I could take it out, but now it was a wrong move. So what I did after that, I took out from legacy boot, then I put back to, I put to UIF, then I put it back to legacy boot, and everything went fine, guys. So let me switch off the machine. So excited! I'm excited to get this right. So give it time. Don't reboot it the way you want. No, don't do that. I'm gonna show you things where what you have to do. What I did is you saw what I did. It didn't work. But then I went back and re-put the settings the way they were. Then everything worked well. So it's taking some time because it had some problems. Okay, it's off. What you do, you on your PC, then when it's in the process, press F2. Okay, didn't go on. Switch on the machine and press F2. F2 is gonna take you to BIOS. You can see here, look what I did. You see, I put it to UIF here, and I put it to, you can look at these settings. This is what you have to do. By the end of the day, you have to use this. This has to be put it out from legacy boot. So you can see after that, also I went to look at secure boot. We're gonna click there. Plus, secure boot is enabled, again, but the system is in UIF with secure boot and also UIF studio, what, you understand? All of this, that's all I did, guys, and then the machine is back. Try to play only with those settings. You put this, if it doesn't work for you, restart it, then you, I showed you how to do that, restart it, then you reboot it again, then you start the system. After starting the system, then you play only with this, because the diagnostics, we wanted to show you if your hard drive is fine. But then, that worked for us, guys, and I'm so glad. I'm gonna restart the computer, you see it's gonna work. I'm 100% happy, guys, and the only trick is to play with your things. The reason why there was no way this hard drive was messed up, why the laptop is brand new, this laptop, you can see how it is, brand new. So the owner told me that he didn't drop it. He's a decent guy. I didn't believe him, so, but also what I told you, can see this is a very decent guy. He puts his laptop in a very decent bag, so everything is fine, guys. So what I'm suggesting, don't forget to subscribe and see you in the next video. Play with those settings only, you're gonna be fine. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.